Well, somebody who is playing that's also dealing with an injury, surprisingly, DeAndre Hopkins came out and said he's dealing with an MCL tear. This is something that is a year recovery for a guy that's 33 years old. It's kind of shocking to me. I'm not going to lie. Like, at first we were thinking, oh, it's just a knee injury. He'll be fine. He'll, you know, 4 to 6 week injury. He came out and said it's a tear. And typically, you know, if a guy tries to play through this, we haven't really seen, like, you know, the effects of that. Like, is this a full season for DeAndre Hopkins? Is he limited and hampered by this all season long? Or is this a guy that just knows how to play through injury? So I think there's a lot of question marks when it comes to DeAndre Hopkins, and he's a player that I've trusted for years. I've always been a DeAndre Hopkins guy, but that lets me know, like, there's a lot of risk with DeAndre Hopkins heading into this season. For me, this obviously I've been a Calvin Ridley guy. If you had doubts about him, this is the kind of injury that lets you know, okay, Ridley's going to be their feature guy. And then when it comes to Tyler Boyd on this team or Treylon Burks, one of those two names might surprise us, Tyler.
Treylon Burks, he's cooked.
Main backup right now because Boyd plays out the slot. So if anything were to happen to DeAndre Hopkins, he enters a starting role.
I don't think he's good. That's the problem. But I, like, for me personally, I was not in on DeAndre Hopkins. I didn't want anything to do with DeAndre Hopkins this year. Like you said, 30, 32, 33 years old, however old he is now. Like, with this injury, I have no interest. And I would not be playing him this week one. I would wait to kind of see how it plays out with him. Also, I want to say they play Chicago, right?
Chicago this week.
And Chicago, honestly, their defense should be very good this year. I think this is a defense that can be very good. It's a tough matchup with a guy who's older, coming off the MCL or playing with the MCL. You have Will Levis, who's questionable, you know, at the quarterback position. I don't want anything to do with him. I do think, like, Calvin Ridley definitely gets a boost here, though. For sure. Like, he's the clear cut number one, in my opinion, in this offense. It really has been this offseason.
Right.
So I think that he definitely gets a boost. But yeah, for like DeAndre Hopkins, I mean, man, like, if you drafted him, you have to know the risk, because there was talks, like, when he first got hurt, that he was going to be out for like the first 3-4 weeks of the season. Then it was, he's going to play. And he's always been this guy who's played through the injuries. But I just think, like, you saw that with Julio too, where he played through the injury.
Yes.
And it finally caught up to him. And I think that this could be a year where it just kind of finally catches up with DeAndre Hopkins, unfortunately.
Yeah, I hope not. I hope you're wrong about that. I hope he's able to shine, especially for a potential Hall of Fame type player.
Yeah. Man, you don't want to see a guy who's been a stud for a while.
Yeah, you don't want to see him have a season like this. It is, you know, and we see these days, and I think a lot of times it's weird because I think for whatever reason, the NFL, and this I know is kind of a sidebar, but the fantasy community wants to put people in their grave, their fantasy grave, before it happens. Like, it always feels like that, man. And, you know, it sucks when you actually start to see a sign of it. And I think we're starting to see a sign of, like, the downfall of DeAndre Hopkins. I'm not trying to say downfall. Maybe plays through and plays incredible. I don't want to say that. Yeah. But it sucks when you start to see these types of things, especially for older players. Because injuries do happen. And one of the injuries that happened to another player that we drafted at the very top of the draft, Christian McCaffrey, dealing with the calf injury, still limited at practice. The expectation is going to be out there on the field. From 0 to 100 percent chance of playing, Christian McCaffrey, who has not seen a whole lot of action this preseason training camp and does have a limited tag coming in, probably will be questionable. What percentage do you think he plays? 100 to 0?
100. He's definitely going to be playing. Now, I will say the only thing, though, like, I would, if you had the space, I would pick up Jordan Mason. Not out of, like, worriness that he's not going to play. Like, I definitely think he's going to play. But the calf strains can be tricky, and especially with the running backs. I forget what the exact number is, but like, you see the fantasy doctors and those kind of guys talk about this all the time, that they are at a high risk of re-injuring it, re-aggravating it. So he's somebody that I think he'll play, obviously, but if there is a chance, like, there could be a chance he does re-aggravate it and then has to miss a few games. And we just know this is one of the best offense in the league, especially for the running back position, where Jordan Mason ever did have that opportunity where he would be the guy. I mean, I would definitely want him for fantasy football. So it's better to be proactive than reactive.
It reminds me a lot of like Elijah Mitchell. It's just, to me, it's not really a sexy pickup. It's not really one of those names I want to have on my bench. But like, I mean, the opportunity could present itself. So I think over the first couple weeks of the season, we see, does Christian McCaffrey look healthy at some point? But at least for now, if there is a limitation on the workload, if he's a 15-touch guy this week instead of being his normal 20 to 25 touches, maybe we see Jordan Mason become a 12, you know, 10 to 12 touch guy, which to me seems screams more like Justice Hill for the Ravens than it does for like, you know, strong RB2 for fantasy.
For sure.
And then the last injury to talk about, actually, I think Christian McCaffrey is one of those players. If you have him, you have to understand what you have. You have an elite fantasy player who a team wants to get to the Super Bowl. They got to keep him healthy throughout that time. So just know what we saw last year may have been the ceiling for Christian McCaffrey. And instead of expecting that kind of season, just know you have one of the more consistent players in one of the best offenses in the league. I think that's how you approach Christian McCaffrey rather than like, should I panic on the injury or is he going to be what I drafted him? Like, you just got to know you drafted a rock solid option at the top. So don't let this injury, don't let a slow start to the season kind of sway you from Christian McCaffrey. Just know he's out there. He's going to perform. He's going to be involved.
Mm-hmm.
Quarterback. For your Pittsburgh Steelers, Russell Wilson, QB1, alert. Now he is dealing with an injury. They're talking multi-week injury potentially for Russell Wilson, who is out of practice today. Justin Fields is at practice. This is, you know, it's not a major thing because Russell Wilson wasn't penned to be the starter for most fantasy teams unless you're in a deep super flex league. You're probably not starting Russell Wilson unless you were just all in on the value late. But this does have a really, really big fantasy impact, in my opinion, because if we get Justin Fields as the starter, that changes a lot of things. That changes where we're ranking him because now we probably have a QB1 type player that is available. Absolutely. So if Russ is out for the first couple of weeks, Tyler, like this is a must pickup, in my opinion. Are you on there with me or how you feeling about
it? I think so. I would want Mahomes, Allen, Hurts, Kyler, A. Rich, and then I'd probably want Justin Fields. Like, I think he's right there because we saw last year, like, you don't have to, and this is kind of the problem we run in fantasy football sometimes. People aren't able to separate real life from fantasy football. Like, Justin Fields may not be a good real life quarterback. Who cares? Like, he runs the football and he's good at running the football, and that matters for fantasy football. So, like, I think he's an absolute rock solid QB1, no matter the matchup, no matter who they have. This is a guy who can run for 100 yards in a game. Like, we've seen him do it. So this is a guy that I would, if I had like, I don't know, Jared Goff as my starting quarterback, 100%, I would want Justin Fields on my team because he's a guy who can outscore Jared Goff easily. Doesn't even have to have a good game in real life, but for fantasy purposes can have an excellent game. And this is also a team that, we know they're going to run the football. Like, this is going to be a smash mouth football team. Arthur Smith gets a lot of hate for how bad of a head coach he is. Offense coordinator, I believe in him to find creative ways to get Justin Fields out there in open space, off on the edge, you know, being able to make these runs, design runs for him. So I think Justin Fields would be, if I had like any of those back end QB ones, 100%, I'd be picking up Justin Fields. Now, if I have like Hurts or somebody, I mean, sure, I'd still pick him up just to block my, you know, opponents potentially if I have somebody. But like, I wouldn't go like, not somebody I would really want to throw in my starting lineup. Definitely those guys, but a back end QB one for sure.
And it depends. Like, it depends on how long Russ is out. Because if Russ is out 2-3 weeks,
I mean, say he looks good though.
Yeah, and he might have an opportunity he never gives back away. And it's that really is the complication with fantasy sometimes, is knowing how long is the opportunity and what do they do in their opportunity. Obviously, like you mentioned, Arthur Smith is going to find creative ways. He made Desmond Ritter look okay at times last year. Desmond Ritter just got cut by the Arizona Cardinals, who need a backup quarterback. So for me, I look at Justin Fields and I'm like, you know, you really don't have a whole lot of weapons here. And what do we love about him? You talked about it, the rushing upside. Really, all you got is George Pickens, because you got Van Jefferson, Roman Wilson, Calvin Austin, Cordell Patterson, an outcast, a nobody, like a bunch of misfits. So it's going to be the ground game. It's going to be Justin Fields. If he does get the opportunity to start, they have not declared Russell Wilson out. Major concern, though, if you have Russell Wilson or depending on a major concern, find a way to get Justin Fields on your roster if you can. All right? That's if you have Russell Wilson or you're in a super flex league. Single QB leagues, Tyler alluded to it already. The only reason you'd want to do it is if you waited on quarterback really late and you're looking for some upside. Mm-hmm. Outside of that, anything else before we head into week one, Tyler, and we see your boy Kamani Vidal sit the bench?
I mean, he probably will sit the bench week one, but it's okay. We'll see what happens.
My guy Rashad Bateman didn't do shit either.
Yeah. It's just a tough. I mean, like, as always, it's week one. I mean, you're going to see massive overreactions to stuff. I mean, I talked about this a little bit ago or in one of my videos. Like, last year, everyone was panicking about Jahmyr Gibbs after week one, and he ended up finishing the season as a top 10 running back. Like, you're going to see so many overreactions after week one, and it's just really important to look at, you know, how much these players are actually playing. Because if they are losing snaps in week one to other guys, then yeah, that's significant. But if they just don't, if they have dud games, but they're seeing the work, that happens. Like, it happens all the time. So you gotta, it's important to react, not overreact. So just don't overreact to week one. But it's also just fun. It was great to watch football last night.
It was great to watch football. Usage trumps production. Trump's production. And even with rookies, we know rookies early on, a lot of times they have to ramp up to the NFL game. You mentioned Jahmyr Gibbs. So some of the rookies that we love may not be studs right out the gate. So, yes, it's important to patience. Patience with your players. I'm not reacting extremely one way or the other till about week four. I know I talked about Kelce and Andrews, but we're not – extreme reactions don't happen until about 4 or 5 weeks into the season. But – we got football this weekend, Tyler. Should be a good one, and we'll be back probably earlier than we were this week talking more about the games from last week and previewing the next week. But until then, we will see y'all next time. Peace out.
Peace.